Welcome to week four. Last week we looked at special matrices and we looked at matrix vector multiplication, and we spent a lot of time with slicing and dicing. This week we're going to do some more of that. We're going to combine special matrices with matrix vector multiply and demonstrate how slicing and dicing makes everything so much easier. However, before we do that, we're going to start with a simple example of a Markov process. That then motivates how systems of linear equations can also be thought of as matrix vector multiplication. And it also leads towards the second topic of the week, which is matrix-matrix multiplication. Okay, let's have a look at predicting the weather. Here we have a very, very naive model for predicting the weather. And I assume we're going to see lots of discussion about how naive this really is on the discussion board. But that's not the point. The point is that it's a very simple example of something known as a Markov process. Okay, what's going on here? Well, we live in a very simple world. And in that world, the weather is only sunny, cloudy, or rainy. And if today it is sunny, then there's a 40% chance of it being sunny tomorrow, a 40% chance of it being cloudy tomorrow, and a 20% chance of it being rainy. And similarly, you can go from cloudy to sunny, cloudy to cloudy, cloudy to rainy, etc. So this table just kind of summarizes what the probabilities are going from one kind of weather today to another kind of weather tomorrow for any day. Now, what does that mean? Well, we can ask the question, if today is cloudy, what's the probability that tomorrow it is sunny, cloudy, or rainy? Well, why don't you just take a minute to go and do homework 4.1.1, and then I'll see you in the next video.